people may be wondering what we do as an organization. It's a faith-based organization. My Never My Hero is a faith-based organization. This is what Christ wants us to do. Because sometimes we mistake our identity as Christians. We believe that Christianity is a religion. No, Christianity is not a religion. Christianity means we are living the life of Christ. We are doing those things Christ wants us to do. But there's only one religion in the Bible. And that religion is in James chapter 1, verse 27. The only true pure religion that Christ wants us to do is to take care of the poor, the orphans, the less privileged. And so going to Uganda is part of my religion, to practice my religion. But in this case, I wanted to see and to know about this country, Uganda. How can we help? What are the medical needs? Mm-hmm. What do we need to bring on ground? And how do we affect those people? Mm-hmm. I wasn't going there. When my wife says that I handle the ministry aspect of the organization, doesn't mean that we preach only. We demonstrate it. That's when Christianity, as our culture, comes into play in our religion. Now, our religion is doing good. You know, doing good with no exception, whether you're Muslim, whether you're a Hindu, whether you are, whatever you are, my religion needs you. Because love is a language that nobody rejects. Mm-hmm. So my religion is a message of love, the love of Christ. Nobody rejects it. Christianity is also a culture. You know, culture is defined as a way of life of a people. Mm-hmm. So Christianity is my culture. This is my life, doing good, demonstrating the love of Christ. Mm-hmm. You know, love my neighbor as myself. Mm-hmm. So that's what I went to Uganda to do. But I was really, really overwhelmed mm-hmm. with the hospitality,
yeah.
with the love I received in Uganda.
This trip was birthed through vision.
That's right.
That you had, right?
That's
so
right.
Share a little bit about that and share about the kind of circumstances that we had to overcome before it actually happened.
The circumstances, we had several ups and downs,
yeah.
you know, several challenges. I always tell people, if you're a Christian and you don't have challenges, then it means you're a cousin to the devil. You know,
yeah.
So devil doesn't disturb his cousins. You know, devil doesn't trouble the demons. So when you are going through any challenges in the ministry, I mean, you know that God is in your case. He's on your file is on his table. And devil is not happy that the file is on the table. So when we had this vision, and having gone through those challenges that I saw them going through, mm-hmm. that really shook my faith. Mm-hmm. Like for instance, when I asked them, what can we do to support mm-hmm. them? Individually, we meant individually. And they spoke in unity, in one time. Mm-hmm. They didn't rehearse it. The first woman said, please, our children, we want them to go to school. Mm. And education in Uganda is very expensive. They were literally crying. We don't need money, but our children, we want them to go to school,
have
to go
future.
To vocational, we want them to have a better future that yeah. we do not have. Mm-hmm. All of them that spoke in tears, they asked for the same thing. And what did they ask me? Nothing else but education.
Education. You know what I've noticed is that the value of education is really appreciated by people who don't have access.
That's right.
Very, very appreciated. And an education can really change your destiny. I mean, I feel like I'm a product of good education and, you know, you have more options. You can enlighten the community. You can go further in life. And then you can bring people behind you for sure. Education is also a huge necessity. And everybody doesn't get that access, which is unfortunate.
Education should be a right of every child.
Yeah.
You know, we in this part of the world are so privileged. I always tell anyone from this part of the world, if you don't have education, blame yourself. Because here, the government made it easy for anyone to go to school through student loans or whatever. You know, you can have personal loans, line of credit, just to go to school. It's not like that in Africa. Mm. You pay from your pockets.
Yeah. Every level.
Every level. You pay for your, there's nothing free. So that breaks my heart because I am a product of that situation. My mom, we are nine in the family. you know, and she had to fend for everyone to go to school. Some of us had to drop so that others could climb. We have only one girl in the family, and her dream was to make sure her daughter went to school. So I had to pave way to make sure she went to school. As she got her PhD, we made sure she got to the highest level of education. You know, so I know what education means. Mm. And we want every child in Africa to be educated. Let it be their right. So now that vision, we have enlarged it, you know, to become an institution. By the grace of God, my neighbor, my hero, wants to set up a free education system from primary to high school, you know, to help them go to school. And the community provided land. They say, hey, you can have this for school. We need school. We want our children, we want to reduce crime. Our children have been tormented with drug addiction because we could not afford education. Our daughters are into prostitution because they are working hard to take them to go to school. If your organization can bring this to us, you have won souls for Christ. And imagine when you have such in a Muslim community, in a community that doesn't know Christ, when in a Christian community that doesn't believe that God is still in the business of doing good, and you have such, imagine the good you have done to those children, that you have impacted them with knowledge, impacted them with something that that will change their destiny forever. So that is why we are believing God. We will be going back to Uganda maybe this summer to develop the land and not to deliver the land.
Yeah. So, you know, there's always something that we can give. There's always something that we can share. There's always someone to help us.
Visit us at our website, www.myneighbormyhero.org. Myneighbormyhero.org. Click to subscribe to the website. You'll get more information. But don't forget, click to donate on the mission for Uganda. It's on our web. Every information you need is on the website. And about the school we talked about, you know, is a project that we must, you know, do. Give those children life. Give them an opportunity to be educated. Mm-hmm. So we believe in you, and we trust that God will bless them through you. You are here in America, wherever you are in the world, you are a neighbor. Yeah. To a hero out there. Those children are our heroes. We are not their hero, you know. So they are our heroes. We are just a neighbor helping them to climb the ladder. So we've climbed the ladder. We don't want to pull the ladder up. We want to leave the ladder for others to climb. So please visit the website. Again, myneighbormyhero.org, and click to donate, and also click to subscribe. You can email us for more info. For more information, please email us at info@myneighbormyhero.org.